अस्सलाम वालेकुम
वालेकुम अस्सलाम सर। अच्छा
हाउ आर यू। ओनली सिक्स पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर देयर, सेवन हेयर। हाउ आर यू ऑल? चलो, सो डिड यू रीड द पीडीएफ व्हिच आई सेंट यस्टरडे? ऑल ऑफ यू Let's friends.
Yes, sir.
Is I'm audible? Did you read the PDF which I sent yesterday?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, friends. Sir.
Only two are lying me.
Yes, sir.
What about Shaima, Sheikh, Vidya, Mois, Khalil? Only two are replying. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You sure? Can I ask the question from that PDF?
Yes, sir.
Okay, mashallah. Beta, please do read the things that I send, because the next day I will definitely, inshallah, ask from that part. Okay. So from onwards, please remember the things which I am sending to you. Okay. So today we are going to start. Another thing that is so open page number 20, page number 40 beta. Open page number 40. Did you see it? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Beta, boys, if you are not responding, I will note your name, beta. Okay. Still, two or three girls only responding, and two and three boys. Waalaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, so today we are going to start compound. Okay. So, what is compound? It's a pure substance that are formed when two or more elements combined chemically in a definite proportion, okay, are called compound. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, compound is basically, this is an important characteristic of compound, that proportion should be definite. There should be a fixed proportion. Okay. For a substance, for a pure substance to be called as a compound, there should be a definite proportions. Okay. And they are formed when two or more elements combine. Okay. And their combination should be chemically. Is it clear to you, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, yes, boys. Huzaifa Khan? Huzaifa Khan? Huzaifa, you are not responding. I read your name. Yes, so Abdul Rahman, are you there? Abdul Rahim. It's okay, Munazza. You are late, not joined. Okay. Yeah.
Sorry, sir. Actually, I got 3 minutes late in joining.
Okay. Yes, Huzaifa, you didn't respond to me. Okay. Abdul Rahim, are you?
Yes, sir.
Huzaifa, yes, please tell me what is compound, okay, in your own words, okay?
Your own words.
What is a compound? Huzaifa, you are not responding. Abdul Rahim,
When two or more elements combine chemically in definite proportion are called compound.
But I just now say this, don't read from the book, okay? Who or in your own words. Okay, give me an example. Give me an example and tell me how they are, what are the constituents of that compound. Give me some example of compound, Uzaifa Khan.
CO2.
Okay.
Glucose and common salt.
How could you say that CO2 is a compound? First of all, please, students, listen to the instructions again. Okay. No one will speak in Urdu and nothing will be written in chat in Urdu. Okay. First thing is that. Another thing is that, please, I don't want to see anyone opening the camera. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Please tell me why CO2 is a compound. Yes. From the girl side, who will give the answer?
Second item.
Sadia, you please.
Second item.
Sadia, you tell me.
Okay, sir.
Okay,
compounds are pure
substances. I am just asking why CO2 is considered as a compound. Just give me this answer.
So can I tell? CO2 is considered as a compound because where two elements are combining, that is that carbon dioxide and oxygen, and they are in fixed proportion, and here they are combining chemically. And they are forming a pure substance, which is carbon dioxide.
Yes, anyone else? Yes, you can.
Sir, can I just say something?
How can I say?
Wait for a second. Fatima Zafar, you are saying something?
So you, yes, sir, I am saying that. Can I tell the answer?
Yes, please. Let me, okay.
Fatima Zafar. Sir, I just wanted to add something in Sadia's answer. Can I just add?
Wait for a second. Let her complete first.
CO2 is a compound because in a CO2 compound, there are two oxygen atoms and a single carbon atom which are bonded together.
Yes. Nabia, what are you adding to it?
Sadi actually said that carbon dioxide, in CO2, she said that two elements are combining, carbon dioxide and oxygen.
You just said two elements of carbon or two atoms of carbon. Yeah. One atom of carbon.
Yes, sir. I said it by mistake.
Okay. So this is CO2 is a compound because two oxygen atoms combined with a one atom of carbon in a fixed ratio. Okay. So that's why it's a compound and they are chemically combined. So this is important thing. Okay. So like glucose C6H12O6. Okay. And like H2O. Here, hydrogen is two atoms. And oxygen, one atom, they are combined chemically in a fixed ratio. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Like
yes,
sir. Glucose also, as it is in page number 40. So this is very important characteristic. Another important characteristic you already learned in previous classes that compound has a unique property that are different from the properties of individual elements. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, Sadika Shakil, are you there? Sadika Shakil, beta?
Yes, sir.
Please
yes, sir.
Tell me this thing, how the properties of the constituent compound is different from the compound itself. Yes.
So can you please repeat your question once?
I'm saying that as we know that compound has a unique properties like but the constituent element has its different property from the compound.
Sir, can I tell?
No.
Sadiqa, can I tell?
Listen, beta, yesterday or today also I'm saying this. If Sadiqa, you are not responding, please tell me sorry, sir, so that I can move to another student. Is it clear, Sadiqa, Shakil, beta? Because others should also get their chance to speak. Okay, Sadiqa, you are not, last time I'm saying, are you able, giving me answer or should I move to another student? Yes, Shaima, please you tell me.
The properties of compound is different from its constituent elements. For example, we take the example of water, H2O. Water is made up of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Okay. So this water, it extinguishes the fire.
Okay.
And hydrogen, it burns, means it is burns readily.
And it's a combustible oxygen, gas. Yes, it's a combustible, it burns easily. Yes.
Yes, it's a combustible, and oxygen, it supports burning.
So this is clear to all of you, all the students, that the constituent.
So,
yes. Yes, boys and girls, this is understand. You understood this? That all constituents
yes,
of compound have yes. a different property yes, as compared to compound itself. Okay. Another important property, I'm sharing some properties also to you. Okay. Let just wait for a second. Wait for a second. Okay, so another thing is that depending upon the depending upon the type of compound or chemical bonding, okay, between the atoms, compound can be of two different types, okay, electrovalent compound or covalent compound. Basically this is this division is based on chemical bondation, how bonds, how atoms and molecules are bonding each other. Okay. So this is compound. This, are you all seeing this my screen? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so
yes,
compound
yes,
is an
yes,
element which
sir.
Is present in a fixed proportion. Okay. So the property and another one is the properties of compound are different from those of its element. Yes, I told this. Its constituent can be separated only by chemical methods. Yes, please, anyone can explain this point. Its constituent can be separated by chemical methods only. Yes, this I want this answer from the boys' side. And last one is a compound is always homogeneous in nature. Yes, yes, boys, are you listening to me?
Yes.
Please tell, explain this point. Its constituent can be separated chemically methods only. Nabiya, will you tell me this answer? I hope you will tell this answer to me.
So can I tell this one?
Yes.
So basically, a compound Yes, a compound Navya. Basically may be broken down into its constituent elements, but only chemically, by only chemical means. We cannot employ, you know, physical separation methods to obtain, you know, for example, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen from sugar. So that's how, you know, a compound can only be separated, the constituents of compound can only be separated by chemical means. They cannot be separated by physical
methods. Yes, Abdul Rahman, my voice is audible to you. Sorry for the interruption. Yes, Abdul Rahman. Sorry, Abdul Rahim, my voice is audible. Yes, Navya, please continue. Please, sorry for the interruption. Navya, continue.
No, that's okay. So, for example, like sugar. So, the constituents of sugar are carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. And okay. They can only be separated by, you know, chemical means, by chemical methods. They cannot be separated by physical methods. And that's how
okay.
The compound...
Yes, Munazza, you are telling something? Okay, thank you. Munazza?
No, sir. I was just asking that if I can give answer.
Now you can give another example if you want.
Okay, sir. So I'll go with a simple example.
That's very good.
Water.
Exactly.
Water
yes,
is H2O, hydrogen and oxygen. It is chemically bounded with each other.
Okay.
We cannot use winnowing or sieving to like to take out hydrogen and oxygen from out from water. We need some chemical separation because energy exchange has taken place.
Okay.
So now we need to balance that energy exchange again to make them the same.
Okay.
So for this, we use electrolysis to separate hydrogen from oxygen.
Okay, that's nice. So is it clear to everyone this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I am just reading that compounds. Beta question was that please give me an example to show how the constituents properties of constituents are different from compound. And another question was that why only chemical methods are used to separate the compound, not physical methods. Okay. So another thing is that depending upon the bonding type of bonding, okay, compounds are divided into two types, that is electrovalent and covalent. Basically, you have to read these things in deep in the further classes. Okay, I'm just telling in brief that electrovalent bond or ionic bond are those in which there is a transfer of electrons takes place. Okay, and covalent bonding is that bonding in which sharing of electron takes place. Is it clear, everyone?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, mashallah. Yes, so? Yes, I'm saying that. Yes, you all open. Yes, you all open this page 41.
Sir, we have opened.
Okay, so it is written electrovalent and covalent. Okay, so electrovalent bonding, basically it's a type of bonding. And this bonding takes place, and this bonding in compound takes place when they this takes place when there is a transfer of electrons takes place. Okay, and covalent bond or covalent compound is formed when there is a transfer of electrons takes place. In order to complete the octet, this you have to learn in the upcoming classes, inshallah. So this thing is clear. Okay, about properties of compound. What is compound? Okay.
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Mashallah. So now here comes impure substances. Okay, we have completed the topic pure substances. Here comes impure substances. Is it clear? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, please lower your hands. Okay, so yes, boys, please tell me about impure substances. Yes, Labib, are you there, Labib?
Sir, can I tell?
Sir, can I tell?
Only Labib, you tell me. Labib? Yes, this now only boys will tell, because actually 4 or 5 girls are answered me all the questions. Now this time for boys. Yes, Labi, are you there? Yes, yes, sir. Yes, Labi, you are saying. Yes, I am saying that. Tell me impure substances as it is given on 41.
Sir, can I tell?
Labi, are you Labi, beta?
Sir, can I tell?
Labi, you are not responding. Yes, Akif, you tell me.
Sir, can I tell?
Akif?
Yes, sir. A mixture is made up of two or more substances.
Hold for a second. Labi, please respond me fast, okay? Because if I move to another student, then you raise the hand and then, sir, please be attentive, okay? Yes, Akif, I'll give you another question, Labi, okay? Yes.
That are chemically combined, therefore the substance or component they make up a mixture retain their individual properties.
Okay. Read quietly this part, first paragraph, and answer me. Don't read from the book. Okay. Read it and answer me. A mixture is made up of two or more. Okay. Yes, Yasir. Akif, read till then. I ask the question to Yasir. Yes, Yasir, you there?
Yes,
you answer
sir.
This. You, yes, please sir. Answer. Impure substances or mixture, what are they?
So what?
I am saying that on page number 41, there is a heading naming impure substances or mixture. Please go through it and tell me what is mixture.
Yes, sir.
Can I tell?
Yes, sir.
Sir, two or more elements and compound of pure substance is called a mixture.
Are you sure you are saying two or more compounds? So two or more things are also present in compound also? Then what is the difference then?
Sir, no chemical.
Yes, Umar Rashid, please tell me.
Sir,
yes?
A mixture is made up of two or more pure substance. They cannot be represented by a chemical formula.
And anything left in this definition to make it complete?
I said hello? They are homogeneous or heterogeneous.
Okay, and still something missing. Yes, Al-Qamar Mashood, are you there?
So their composition may vary.
Okay, very good. Yes, Al-Qamar Mashood. Al-Qamar, you are not responding. Labib, now you are able to answer me this thing, impure substances. Labib, are you there? Yes, a mixture is a material made of two or more different substances which are not chemically combined. Yes, this is important, not chemically combined. Okay. Yasir Akhir didn't tell this point. Okay. So, for a mixture or impure substance, there are some conditions that they are not chemically combined. Okay. So basically, is it clear to everyone? Impure substances. Some examples are given here, like salt,
yes,
solution.
Sir.
Okay. And,
yes, sir.
And this thing important that they are separated. They can impure substances can be separated.
Sir, can I tell?
Yes, sir. Impure substances can be separated using physical methods.
For example,
winnowing, sieving, and like for example, there is one decantation, sedimentation.
Yes. Okay. So these are the several physical methods by which mixture can be separated. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So there are some characteristics also given on page 41. Okay. That a mixture does not have a definite composition. Hence, it is not represented by a chemical formula. Okay. So you can make a question from here also that what is the reason of a mixture that it cannot be represented by a chemical formula? So students, also you have to make your own questions in between the lines, okay? So that you can deeply understand the chapter. So this thing is understood, that why mixture is not represented by a chemical formula?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, mashallah. Another characteristic of mixture is that a mixture does not have a specific melting and boiling point, a characteristic color, odor, taste. The proportion of the amount of components decides the physical properties like melting and boiling point, color, odor, taste, etc. of the mixture. Yes, from the boy side. Yes, from the boy side, please tell, who will tell this, explain me this point.
Sir, can you repeat your question again?
You have the book. Read point number 3, point number 2, under the characteristic of mixture on page number 41.
Okay, sir.
So can I explain?
Yes, Ubaida, you tell me. Ubaida? You're not responding me?
So can I tell?
Yes, sir.
Whether you are not responding me?
Yes, sir. Tell.
Just, I'm saying that,
sir,
in the characteristics, it is written that a mixture does not have a specific melting and boiling point and the characteristic smell, taste, odor. Then the proportion of the amount of components. Okay, the amount of component decides the physical properties like melting and boiling. This tell me how, give me with example that how the proportion of the amount of component decides the physical properties. Mehtab Nadir, you are not responding, brother. Yes, Mehtab Nadir. Only 3 or 4 girls, Sadia, Fatima Zafar, Nabiha Munazza, Sadiqa Shakil. Only these girls are replying. What about the others? Yes, who will answer this beside these girls? Yes. Is I'm audible to you, everyone? Yes, class.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
So could you repeat the question once again?
I am saying that the components of the mixture decides the physical properties. Okay. As there are no fixed physical properties. So please tell me how the component decides the properties. Who will answer?
Sir, can I answer?
Yes, sir, you tell me, please.
Sir, this is because every element have different melting and boiling point, different odor, different taste, because of which there's not a specific, anything specific in it.
This I am asking that why? They are different.
Sir, can I tell?
Sir, because they are not chemically combined.
Yes, Aksha. Hussain, you are saying something.
Okay, sir. Sir, I think your question is what that compound of a mixture decide the physical properties, why, right?
Yes, tell me the ingredients of mixture, how the physical properties differ.
Sir, the from my side, the separation scheme used to separate the mixture is based on physical properties, okay, such as boiling point, melting point, and solubility in a given solvent. Of these three
Beta, components. Who is this? Who said this?
Aksa.
No. Please mute yourself because I don't want to listen any background voice, okay? I am noting the name. I am writing the name.
Sorry, sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Sir, only this much I have on care.
Okay. So, because as there is no fixed ratio, there is no fixed proportion, okay, that's why properties varies. Okay, if you mix, if you make a dough and you increase the water content, okay, then there are changes in physical property. If you take another thing, if you make a sand and water, and ingredients are increased or decreased, then accordingly the properties will change. Is it clear to everyone? Depending upon the amount of components.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Sir. So, in the table 3.3, there is a comparison between pure and impure substances. Okay. So I am reading and listen it carefully. Okay, then I'm going to ask some questions. Inshallah. So in pure substances, they are either an element or compound, as you know. Pure substances are divided into two. That's element and compound. And impure substances, they are a combination of elements and compounds or both. Is it clear? First point? To everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Why is...
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All of you boys?
Yes, sir.
So another point is that, as we know, that pure substances can be represented by chemical formula. And for impure substances, they cannot be represented by chemical formula. I'm very sorry. they are not represented by chemical formula. Okay. Another difference is that pure substances are homogeneous and impure substances may be homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous means same composition and heterogeneous means different. And they have a fixed composition in case of pure substances, and in case of impure substances, their composition may vary. Is it clear? And in
yes, sir.
And in pure substances, as they are formed chemically, so... some energy is involved, okay, and in pure substances their formation does not involve any energy because we are just mixing it, okay, no, there is no chemical bonding. And for pure substance again, they cannot be separated by physical means, as many of the will answer this question. They are not separated physically, but in case of pure impure substances, they can be separated by physical means, okay. As just now, tell me one of the students tell me the example of water, that water lose their identity, means the components lose their identity as compared to its compound. But in case of impure substances, the compound retain their identity or retain their properties. Okay. So I am asking because Labib didn't answer me. Yes, Labib, please first of all get online so that I can read the question when you. Online, okay. Yes, come online, Labib. Yes, Labib. I am saying your names today 4 times, and you didn't reply me. Yes, sir. You are not having a microphone, or you are not. Why you are writing? Please be online so that I can ask you the question. Abdul Rahim. Labib, I'm not chat. Please be on the mic. Abdul Rahim. Yes, from the boy side, who will answer my question? Yes.
Sir,
can you repeat your question?
I didn't ask the didn't say anything. Yes, I want to know how many boys will be able to answer my question by going to ask.
Hi, Muhammad Farhan.
Sir, I can.
Muhammad Adib. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, I didn't ask you anything. So you answer me. Okay. Yes, Muhammad Adib, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm asking you from the previous lecture that summarize me the properties of metals and metals fast.
Sir, metals are lustrous.
Okay.
Means they are shiny.
Please speak a little louder.
They are malleable. It means they can be beaten into thin sheets. They are hard.
They are hard. Listen, they are hard except.
Except sodium and potassium, which can be cut with the knife.
Yes, please, Murshid, who is saying? Yes, please continue.
They are usually solids except mercury.
Okay, Abdurrahman, you don't have mic. Okay.
They are ductile. They are ductile. It means they can be drawn into wires. For example, copper are beaten into wires.
Just tell me about non-metals also.
Non-metals are usually solid, liquid, and gaseous due to temperature. They are soft except diamond.
Who is speaking from behind?
They are non-lustrous and then except graphite and iodine, which are lustrous.
Okay.
They are non-ductile. Except carbon fiber, which are ductile and then drawn into wires.
Okay, let's try.
Okay. Yes.
Sir, metals are.
Yes.
Metals are hard.
Listen. Please briefly compare the differences between pure and impure substances. This is your question. Umrah Rashid, please briefly explain the comparison between pure and impure substances.
Sir, pure substances are either an element or a compound.
Okay.
And impure substances are a combination of elements, of compounds, or both.
You are reading from the book. Please answer me in your own words. Okay, move and answer on in your own words.
Sir, pure substance. A pure substance is made up of two or more substances.
Two or more substances. Okay. Move.
Sir, can I try?
Yes.
Sir, yes, a pure substance is made up of only one type of atoms or molecules, while impure substance is made up of two or more pure substance. And sir, pure substance, they are always homogeneous, and as well as while impure substance, they can be homogeneous or heterogeneous.
Okay. And
sir. Answer.
And other comparison. What are the other comparisons? What are the
differences? While sir, pure substance, they are having fixed composition, and then an impure substance, their composition may vary.
Okay. And give me fast. Reply me fast. The answer.
Sir, in impure substance, they can be separated by physical means, and in pure substance, they cannot be separated by physical means. Their components lose their identity, while in impure substance, their components retain their identity.
Okay. yes, just, sir. Just hold on. Rehma Khalid, are you there?
Yes, sir.